After that, we'll talk about some exercises on gene indexing with support of jsquery. And finally, we come with a Vodka access method. So let's start. The first slide is about history of schemaless data in PostgreSQL. So the first extension who works with semi-structural data, it was hstore, which we designed I and Teodor in more than 10 years ago. Yes. In later, we did a gene index for hstore, and it becomes part of PostgreSQL. And in 9.2, we got a JSON data type, which is was just a string data type, textual data type, without any indexing support. But it was a bit more flexible, more richer than hstore, which because hstore is a k-value model, and JSON is document-based model. Last year, we started a new work, I and Teodor, with support of Heroku. With engine yard, sorry, we started to work on the binary storage for hstore, and we called hstore dot next generation of hstore, and then we switched to the JSONB data type. And so now we have a structured format for storing JSON. It's JSONB. It is submitted and will be available in 9.4. So a lot of community work was done for improving our work, and we are very happy. We want to say many thanks to developers who really did push our work to the production state. And I think that it's still in it still needs some improving. For people who don't know what is JSONB and how it's different from the JSON, this simple select shows all differences. So JSON is textual storage. It's like as is. So if you see, you have white spaces, you see the duplicated keys, everything is as is. In JSONB, we have no white spaces, no duplicates key, and all keys are sorted. So this is all four differences between JSONB and JSON. So why we did this? Because if we see the, because JSONB was designed for performance. And since JSON was already available from 9.2, there were many applications who already use these features like duplicated keys, white space, and so on. So we decided to introduce new separate data type, JSONB. It's more, it's a bit inconvenient, but JSONB now is a, I would say, is a legal data type. And we hope that JSONB will give a push to PostgreSQL, to the NoSQL world. So here is a simple experiment with delicious bookmarks. It's a bit more than 1 million bookmarks. I tested it on my MacBook Air, and we did three tests, input performance, access performance, and search performance. Here is a screenshot of the struct shows one JSON. So it looks like a mess, but it contains all the stuff like objects, arrays, scalars, and so on. So this see that storage, which introduced JB overhead, it's not so much. It's just less than 4%. It's overhead of binary storage for JSONB. Of course, JSON and text presentation looks the same. And input performance. So we use a copy command to load data into a database. And we see that the fastest is text. It's no surprise. JSON is a second because it needs to do some JSON validation. And JSONB is the slowest, but not so much, because it uses also need some validate JSON and put to the binary storage. So here is this overhead of JSONB. Access performance. Access performance, we see that now the winners, that JSONB is about 20 times faster than JSON. It's just because we have binary storage. We don't need to parse. So you see, the base number is just to read data from table. And JSONB is like this and JSON. So we have these numbers. If we subtract base number, we can see this clean number and get a 20 times fast performance win. And now we test search performance. So JSON has no contains operator, so we get the optimal estimates. We use just this query and check just the first element of array. We did not check all element array because we have no just with JSON we have no access to the elements of arrays. Yeah, and this query we got for 10 seconds. 10 seconds. For JSONB, which has binary storage, we have a contains operator, and we got 10 times faster. This is just a sequential, there is no indexes involved. But now we can, for JSONB, because JSONB has binary storage, we can have a gene index. This is just a simple key and values indexes separately and then joined. And we got more than 150% performance. Yes. So this is looks very nice. But we can get 10 times faster if we have another op class for gene, which used on a hash. And we got very, very nice numbers. So JSONB really outperforms JSON. And of course, yes. Yeah, I will show all these numbers. Yeah. Yes, and of course, we can't skip a comparison with MongoDB. So we use one of the latest version of MongoDB. The first surprise that it was so slow to load. You see that 13 minutes to load data into database. And JSONB just took us 43 seconds. And search sequential scan was more or less the same. It's about 1 second, if you remember. It's a 260. I know that there is a 261, but I think it doesn't matter. Yes. Search performance is very fast. It's just 1 millisecond. But JSONB is a bit faster. No, so it, in principle, it doesn't matter. So we can say that JSONB has performance very close to the MongoDB. And let me note that MongoDB uses expression index. So kind of indexes are different in MongoDB and in Postgres. We have a monolithic index which supports search for all keys. For MongoDB, you need to create sort of a special index for this key. Yes. So our index is more universal. And still, we have a comparable performance. So this is a summary. So as we see that JSON is 10 seconds, sexcan, JSONB is a 8.5 milliseconds gene op class. JSONB is, if we use a JSONB pass operation, which is hash-based indexing op class for gene, got the best performance. This is a Mongo. Index size, JSONB op class has a 600 megabytes. And thanks to the work we've done for the gene, because before compression, it was just 850 megabytes. So new version 8.4 will have a much better gene index. And here is you see, we save 160 megabytes. And JSONB path operation is just about 300 megabytes. And if we create expression index on tags, we got just 44 megabytes. And for if you go deeper, we get just 1.6 megabytes expression index. We compare the Mongo, the index for tags. It's just huge, 386 megabytes. And the same, you see, compare 387 with 44 and 100 with 1.6. So it's, I don't know what Mongo did, but it's very huge. Yes. If you see the table size, Postgres is just 1.3 gigabyte. Mongo is much, much bigger. And input performance, incredible. Mongo is 13 minutes, I don't know what. I use the standard procedure Mongo import command. And I try to optimize using Google, but can't find anything like this. Yes. So this is a state of art what we have for 9.4. And thanks for the company Engine Yard who support this work, at least our. Yeah. So this is what we have. Now, currently, we can search JSONB data using contains operator, like this, contains and contained. And it, this operator has index support, gene index support. This here is the syntax, you see. But case should be specified from root. There is no relative key or wildcard on keys. You have to specify all keys, so the full path. We have, of course, we have equivalence operator, JSONB with gene index support. We have an existence operator, so we can check for the key or array of key, any key, and so on. And it also has index support. But we supported only root key. So you don't go, you can't check the deep keys, only took a root level key. So very limited. Yes, and operators on JSONB parts. So we can use like this, of course. No, you understand. It is, looks very ugly and too many functional indexes can be not a good idea. So we decided to continue our work on and did something like JSONB query language. So we introduced something like JSONB query language, more operators on keys, on values, type support, probably schema support, and of course this language could have indexes support. So we introduced jsquery. jsquery is a JSONB query language, which is actually consists of textual data type and match operator. So here's a JSONB. I don't know how to pronounce in English. Yes, at. I don't know. In Russia we say две собаки, like dogs. jsquery. Yeah, but for now we call it match operator.
The idea of syntax was taken from TS,
T search. T search, yes. 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 So here is a BNF diagram. We just for reference, we did not want to explain everything here. You can download presentation and look everything. So we just will explain some important parts. Here is a, what is the path. Even very important, we introduce some signs, you know. Like a number sign. How you say this is a number sign, pound sign, or letter?
Sharp.
Sharp. Okay, we see many different. We say this is DS. So it means any element of array. So this select produce true. You see, we have an array, and we specify keys with the number sharp number sign equal to. So we have two, so it's produce true. And person sign means any key. So the same select, but we specify just here is maybe any key. So it's like also produce true. Asterisk or wildcard, it means anything. Or element array or key, it doesn't matter. So this also produces true. And dollar sign is a current element. So it's very convenient when you have a complex expression. So we can use just like a placeholder, you know.
Like star can assume multiple levels, is that right?
Yeah. Yes.
So it's in effect take A dot B and replace it with star. Is that right?
Yes, that's right. So we check the. You mean what this query?
No, star.
Ah, this is multiple. It's anything, you know.
Right.
Anything, any level.
What?
My question was, it's not simply matching a single level.
Not single level.
Multiple levels.
Just multiple levels. Just go deep.
Yeah.
And. Dollar is a current element which is very convenient to use in complex expressions. And of course, we did not use any quotes, but in some cases, when you want to be sure that it's string, we suggest to use a double quotes, because this can look like not a key.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Is this in?
No. Потом расскажем, да. This is
extension for 9.4.
Yeah. So this is what we just did maybe several hours ago.
Not hours. Weeks or months.
Yeah. And another is value expression. You see this value expression and something like scalar can be checked for using in operator, so it's also true. All expressions produce true. Okay. Test for key existence. So we can just test if there is a key A dot B, it's just equal wildcard. So instead of question sign, we use this expression. And array overlap. So you can check there for overlapping arrays. And array contains. No, and contain. So, yes?
Have you considered having a non-greedy wildcard as well?
What?
Non-greedy wildcard.
Who's that? What's that?
Like your star on the private on the free is one of the greedy wildcard, right?
You want a star that matches one level.
So or as few as possible.
As few as possible.
Right.
Ну, то есть, как мы далеко идем или ближе, самый ближайший? Any.
JS query returns you just true or false. Yes? Just return you which particular pass it matches. So it matches any pass, then JS query returns true.
No, I understand how it works.
Yeah.
It's neither.
Yeah, no, that's not a problem. Okay, here is some example. How it looks. So if you want to find products similar to this ID and have a product sales rank in range between this, on SQL you can write like this. And I don't know how to write. It's boring stuff. Convert a JSON array to the Postgres array and do some. So I just didn't try. In JS query it looks like this. And in MongoDB, it looks also very awkward. Like and arrays.
Like a pearl.
Like a pearl, yeah. So this is just example. Yes, and here are some queries. We check the same query I already shown in the first part. We have one second, and with the JS query, you see, it looks very clear, very short, and it is even faster somehow. We don't know why, but it is even faster, JS query. Yeah. Teodor has some idea why it's faster. Yeah. So we did some op classes for Jin, which support JS query. One is JSONB value pass operations, op classes. The name, we need some suggestion from you, because it means just that value before on top of path. And another is just path value, so value under the path. And this is use Bloom filtering for K matching. So this JSON, you see, transformed to the value, we preserve value. And here is a ord Bloom signature of all keys. So if we have this one, we can use Bloom filtering like we did in Russian doll tree, in RD3 for arrays. And this is good for key matching, so we support wildcard support, but not good for the range query. No, it's worked, but not so good as this one, another opclass, which is hash path. And this ABC, it's translated to the hash of this, to the path, and combined with the value. Also, of course, it has no wildcard support, but it has no problem with ranges. Here's the index sizes. So we see that this new opclasses has the same size and a bit slightly, no, a bit bigger than hash-based old opclass. But we see that this index is designed to support much more richer set of operations. So we now have, we can now work with values and keys. And here are some numbers, sort of how it looks. For example, the same query I shown you several times already. Now we have with indexes, it just has a very, very good performance. Again, like the MongoDB, more or less, or better. And here we have a opclass, we use value path. Value path opclass. And here we use a wildcard, example of wildcard. So you see, asterisk theorem. And the performance a bit still good, but a bit slower because of wildcard. And next we found a Citus dataset, which is a big number reviews from Citus. I don't remember, somebody posted in the mailing list, so I found this. Yeah, probably. I found, we found, and we got just for 3 years, it's just about 3 million reviews, and has this structure. And it's very nice because we have many numbers, so we can show you how to work with numbers, some range operators. And the table size is 1.5 gigabyte, and we run several queries here to find this. The query is very fast. It's just very fast, but here's a very slow. And this is a problem we will discuss on unconference, because unfortunately, JSONB has no statistics. And moreover, it has no access to the planner, doesn't work with JSONB. So if so this expression that we just add, and this is not very selective, this range query. In principle, you do not need to use index for this query. And now we have about 129 milliseconds. Much better, but we, so in principle, yeah.
The same problem is there is with TS query, because the same optimization to take a part of TS query and use an index scan, it's possible with T-search too. So it's not a single type which faces this problem.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and MongoDB just very fast because it doesn't use index on this You see, it uses index only for this key and doesn't is. And index size is 400 megabytes just for these similar products. Yes, but it's much faster. So if we have a planner support, we can rewrite the query like this to emulate that. Imagine that planner has support for JSONB. So to emulate, we got a very good number. Just half of millisecond. So what does it show? It means that Postgres has potential to execute query for half of milliseconds when Mongo does for 7 milliseconds. So we just need statistics and need planner support. This is some roadmap we will discuss on unconference and all people who want to help us, especially Tom Lane, invited to this. Yes. And the nice thing that all this stuff is a just contribution, is a contrib model. So you can download it and use it for 9.4. It is not included to the release, but you can just download, play, and we need your feedback, especially we need some real sample data and queries.
And please excuse us, there is no documentation. Just
actually, you don't need a documentation because everything here. Just download this this presentation. Well, but we want we always need something better. We need a better indexing, and JSON is proven. It's a very efficient, effective index access method. And tomorrow, Heike. And we and Alexandra will talk about new JSON, new improvements of JSON. So I will not stay here about details, but we want to use JSON because it's very good for duplicates. It's very good for duplicates. We need indexing for JSONB with operation on paths and values. Причем paths we want not hashable. We want to have a path as is, but storing paths as it is requires a lot of storage. We did some experiment. We did extract from the delicious bookmark. We extracted unique path and made a btree index. So we have btree index text pattern operation O plus. It is huge. So the size of table is 900 megabytes and size of btree index is very fast. So btree, no way to work with. So we did something like SPGist. We have SPGist, which can be a very good candidate for storing duplicated data, for storing paths. And we actually, we did indexing and we got smaller index, like 600 megabytes. And as Teodor said us, that this night he decreased this size 2 times less. We just had so we just had no time to reindex, you know. But believe that this number will be much lesser. So what's going from this picture? That we want JSON and we want something like SPGist. So here's a need come Vodka. So we need to provide interface to change hard-coded btree, which used in JSON for entry tree, to SPGist. Yes. And we may go even further. For example, we may change btree in posting tree. And then we can get something like GIS-aware full-text search. If we use R3, for example, instead B3. So we have we decided to play with creating new index access method, which we called Vodka. And so this is a name of our talk, creating. And now the most part of this work was done by Alexander Korotkov. So he continue my talk.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't know how to
give me microphone.
Yes. is left for him, and right. Okay.
Sorry.
Okay, no problem. I can stay.
There you go. Uh-huh. Sorry about that. And then this is the other one.
Do not remove.
I don't want to pull. I know how it hurts.
So did you understand the idea? Why we come with vodka? To vodka?
Okay. So if we put the full passes to gene btree, it would be they would be quite long. So and the entry tree in gene would be large. So that's why we can replace it with spgist, spgist entry tree, which could be store prefixes, and then the rest of pass doesn't contain this prefix. But spgist for jsonb would be quite more complicated than just radix 3, because radix 3 is good for keys, but for numerics we need just binary tree to support range queries. And since jsquery for now doesn't support something other than equality for strings, then we store hashes of strings. They are also in radix 3. And the rest of structure is the same to gene. Each tuple in spgist have reference to posting list or posting tree. So, yes, this is interface of vodka. We call this vodka distilling instructions. Vodka have config methods like spgist, and this specify entry tree op class. So this could be spgist op class, gist op class, and so on, any operator class. Equality operator to detect duplicates. So they use the same posting list or posting tree. Compare extract value the same to gene as in gene. And extract query now returns us not just the entry itself, but the operator to scan entry tree and argument to scan entry tree. And this operator can return us one or more of entries. And the consistent and reconsistent method methods are same as in gene. So the size of index using vodka is about, it's a little bit larger than pass value and value pass, but probably it still can be improvement because of Teodor work this night. Yes, and it's also constructing a bit slower, but it also can be improvement. Now we have just prototype. On simple queries, it show about the same performance as gene and even a bit faster. And on numerics, it have similar relation of size and construction time. These data sets have a lot of numerics. And this is overlap query with the Vodka op class, which is appears to be, yes, faster than Gin. Yes, but when we have range queries, it have the same problem with planning. Yes, but also if we can, if we could to put this condition into a check, then it became very fast. This example, the Vodka use the same FASCAN as Gin, but Gin use FASCAN only when you have no partial match. But Vodka have no notion of partial match. It just see if we have one entry or more than one entry matching the operator. Yes, and in this particular case, we have in Gin we have partial match because of range. Yes, but in this particular case, only one entry match this condition, and that's why Vodka can use FASCAN, and this query is much faster. But it's it is about the more advances in Gin FASCAN because Gin can be as faster as Vodka in this case. And also, Vodka also needs some positional information as Gin in posting list and posting trees, because you know in this query, this both quals is about the same element of array, but in index the you can distinguish different elements of array, and then you have a lot of recheck because you retrieve a lot of results from index where different elements of array matching corresponding quals. So positional information could help us a lot because most part of time we spend in recheck in heap. So also there is a different kind of Vodka, and we can implement very many useful op classes with Vodka. Это Федя расскажет или я? Okay. For example, the case that we call spaghetti indexing. So imagine you have very long spaghetti, and you want to find the spaghetti which swirled to your fork. So if you have MBR approach, each spaghetti have a very large MBR with R3, you know, and then you will have to do almost a sequential scan even if you have an index. So this the spaghetti case is hard for R3. This example in Ottawa, York and George Street. Yes, you will have very large MBRs for them. But if you will have not one MBR, but multiple boxes, then you can have much better covering without extra space, without so much of extra space. So Vodka allow you to write such a class. In extract method, you divide one geometrical object into several bounding boxes. So it's R3 Vodka. Yes, entry tree would be R3 based gist. We need some algorithm for converting polygons with rectangles, but there are some researches on it. Oleg did Google it and found several articles. And we need support of this work. We hope that PostGIS would help us. Also, Vodka have several problems. Yes, at first, we need to somehow update item pointer in entry tree. Using current interface of access method, we can only insert new entry and do vacuum somewhere. But it's quite weird and expensive. Probably we need a new method to do this. Also, if you will implement Vodka op classes in extension, now it's quite hard to get OIDs of op classes and operators. But it's I think it's a minor problem. Yes. Current prototype storing entry tree in separate file with separate fixture relation data, which it construct on the fly. This is just a prototype. And the question is, what is correct infrastructure to handle? But we need to discuss it on the unconference. And another question is future of Vodka, so-called Vodka Plus, to replacing posting tree with arbitrary access method as well. Not only entry trees, but posting tree. But in this situation, you definitely should to store multiple posting trees in the same file. And there is a lot of questions. What interface should handle this? Should we pass to the access method its root block number? How to vacuum this? So a lot of questions. In the summary, we have JS query for 9.4. It has JSONB query language, two GNOP classes, and you can find it on my GitHub. We have prototype of Vodka access method. We have a lot of plans of improving its infrastructure. And our work was supported by Heroku. Many thanks to them. And that's all. Meet us in Madrid, and we hope we will have better Vodka then.
Asked me about how to understand the acronym Vodka.
Yes, it was quite hard to invent this acronym. Yes, but we have a recursive acronym: Vodka optimize, then reform case array.
Array.
Array. Yes.
So questions.
But I believe we already run out of time. Yes. So we'll
have in Saturday we have an unconference.
Yes.
We'll be available for any discussion. So. Yes.
So all the index features you have, couldn't they also be applied to the JSON thing without the D?
In principle, yes, it's possible, but I believe it's hard to do just JS query matching operator, which will have to parse JSON. I don't think Teodor like to do this.
But just cast JSON to JSONB.
Yes, you can just cast. Yes, because you know, if you have, for instance, duplicate case in JSON, JS query anyway can't distinguish them. So. And can distinguish the order of keys. So cast is an option, yes.
So I'm wondering, is there any existing languages for querying JSON out there?
Yeah, there are many languages. We checked them and then decided better to write our one.
Okay.
There is a research paper, you know, big research paper about 11 JSON query language, but they look so ugly.
So you have seen the MongoDB query language. So you have seen the MongoDB query language. We don't like this query language.
Yeah, if you want to write the MongoDB query language, not that it's any better, but for adoption purposes, how hard would that be?
Ты понял вопрос?
Sorry, what we
can you repeat?
So for the MongoDB
I don't know, you probably could write just cast from JSON of MongoDB to jsquery. I believe the jsquery support all of.
How long
we can answer until try.
How long it took you to create this?
1 week maybe?
No. jsquery.
jsquery.
The first version.
First version was about 1 month. And then modification was very fast. What some operations for, because the most problem is the internal representation of jsquery. To be comfortable to work on it.
So it can be a separate project to make a driver for MongoDB or cast operation.
Can you module build in something like C++ language?
C?
C language?
Yes.
Yes.
Windows Flex and no parse.
I don't know, maybe we can release it like a PGXN, I don't know, better. Or just provide Git, I don't know. But first we need your support to just download, test, because we need to find all bugs. We have time to 9.4.
Okay. Cool. Okay.
Mm-hmm. How many looked into the details of the format of the binary format for storing the
JSON? Yeah, we have a separate presentation we can find from Dublin.
Yeah.
We have a.
Just as out of curiosity, if you have how look at the some already established or at least established serialization formats for JSON, such as universal JSON or JIN, which are special thing, not very widely known, but it's designed specifically for reducing the storage size for a given JSON.
Your question is very long.
too long to read.
I mean, it's a serialization format. It is very special. And I don't know, I'm just guessing.
So, JSONB is a format optimized for fast access.
Now, serialization of JSONB, you bring send receive function what is
You mean send receive over network or storage in the files in the on the disk? So JSONB is optimized for fast access. So it stores the keys sorted, so you can use a binary search to find the particular key. So it's really fast. So let's discuss this on conference.
Yeah, okay. We can't really hear you with the NDA, so that's where I think it's.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So.